Yeah. It's Nigga IQ, man. And I'm back, man. Back with something for y'all, man. A little something special right now. So I want to say, first of all, it's crazy, bro. I was just talking to my homie today. He was like, "That's crazy. Like, how hard, like, Bulgaria fuck with me, bro. I fuck with y'all too. Y'all got some, like, I didn't know y'all had a culture like that, like, as far as, like, hip hop and shit. Like, I'm late. I'm just late. You know what I'm saying? I'm late to the shit. So excuse me. I'm usually early on. But yeah, y'all got me actually, like, other people from other countries hitting me. I'm like looking into their shit. I'm trying to see what's, you know what I'm saying? So I really, because normally if I wanted to, I probably would have turned. I'd be, somebody from somewhere else hit me like, "Yo, play this shit from, I'm from wherever I'm from and play it." I probably wouldn't even play it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Not on some just fuck it, but just like, nah, it's some rap shit. But yo, so I'm going to say less. So I thought tonight would be a good night, you know. It's late night IQ, you know what I'm talking about. So I thought tonight would be a good night to take a trip to Bulgaria. You feel me? Like, you hear me say I want to come down there. So I'm like, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go to Bulgaria, bro. Fuck it, nigga. Right now, while I'm doing reactions, fuck it. We about to slide. We, you hear me? Yeah, hey, let's go. You hear me? So we bought the slide. This next one right here called "The 10 Most Beautiful Places in 2021 in Bulgaria." So let's slide, man. Yeah.
The most beautiful places to visit in Bulgaria.
Shut up, man. We push, man.
Bulgaria is located in the southeastern Balkans at the crossroads of Europe and Asia.
Okay.
It's one of the oldest countries in Europe, founded in the 7th century. It borders Turkey, Greece, Macedonia, Serbia, Romania, and the Black Sea. And landforms include mountains, plains, and the coastline.
That shit look crazy.
Bulgaria is still considered to be off the beaten track for Western tourists, because the country has a bit of everything, and all at very affordable prices. The mountain slopes of Bansko and Pamporovo attract skiers in the winter, and the Black Sea beaches draw the crowds in the summer months. The Black Sea famous coastline. A good place to start is the country's famous beaches, which has long stretches of sandy beaches dotted with hotels, traditional fishing villages, and historical sites. Tourists flock to the glitzier resorts of sunny beach and golden sands. 10 beautiful places in Bulgaria.
Let's slide. Roll up. They got the music.
Koprivtitsa, a fantastic place to explore in Bulgaria. Located 2 hours east of Sofia, you'll feel that you're being transported back to 1876 when Bulgarians fought against their Ottoman rulers. Inside the colorful houses, representatives of Bulgarian national revival architecture of the 19th century.
Got the trees
local
coming
patriots
out the window.
Plotted their rebellion leading up to the first shot being fired in the ultimately unsuccessful April uprising. The village is full of memorials and museum houses, displaying ethnographical treasures, old weapons and farm implements, national costumes, artwork, and jewelry. The Efsinograd Residence. The Efsinograd Residence is one of the most romantic buildings in Bulgaria. Located 8 kilometers north of Varna, this 19th century palace was often used as a holiday home for royalty. The building was built after Prince Battenberg visited Varna in 1880 and was impressed by the local nature. The exterior of the mansion is in French style of the 18th century. It is ornate, romantic, and quite beautiful. The interiors are luxurious, with marble fireplaces,
that's nice as hell.
French chandeliers, large dining halls,
it look like some
antique furniture,
exquisite.
And rare paintings. The grounds surrounding the park are no less impressive. French park architects were designed to lay out the 800-acre park.
I can tell.
They planted more than 500 species of flowers in the grounds and greenhouses. A winery was added to the palace in 1891 and still produces excellent wines today. It produces Chardonnay, Riesling, Traminer, Muscat O'Toole, and Vratza Muscat wines. Zarevna is a village in central eastern Bulgaria,
like
part of Kotel
LA,
municipality in Sleven province.
Like that
the
suburb.
Village is set in a small valley at the southern foot of the eastern Balkan Mountains. Is an architectural reserve of national importance consisting of more than 200 wooden houses from the Bulgarian National Revival period 18th and 19th century. and is quickly developing as tourist destination. The village emerged between the 12th and 14th century and grew to become a cultural and handicraft center in the 18th century. Nisebr, also known as the Pearl of the Black Sea, the historic town of Nisebr, dates back to antiquity, when it was founded as a Thracian settlement known as Menebria. Greeks, Romans, Byzantines, Bulgarians, Crusaders, and Ottomans all took turns fortifying the ancient town and the narrow peninsula on which it is located. Today, a stroll on its cobblestone streets will bring you to remnants 40 brick churches, dating back as far as the 5th century. The beautiful town is such an important site that it's recognized by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site. Belogradchik, an ancient and important beauty spot and a stunning natural attraction in Bulgaria. Belogradchik Fortress is a man-made construction set against a stunning outcrop of rocks. The combination is so unique and picturesque that it seems to have been lifted straight out of a fairy tale. What's even more unique than the fortress is the surrounding countryside. The Belogradchik Rocks was named in 2009 as Bulgaria's candidate to be selected as one of the new 7 wonders of nature. Is in stunning arrangement of strange shaped sandstone and conglomerate rock formations. Rila Monastery, the most famous monastery in Bulgaria, known as the Jerusalem of Bulgaria. This picturesque Eastern Orthodox monastery is located in the forested mountains less than 2 hours south of Sofia.
It's definitely worth a
pilgrimage visit. Named for Saint Ivan of Rylski, the monastery has been built, burnt, and rebuilt over the centuries, with the latest construction dating to the 1800s. Enter the courtyard and you will be stunned by the perfect harmony of the church, with its graceful arches, set under a row of sculpted gargoyles, tiled roofs, and 5 domes reaching towards the sky. In the distance are the peaks of the Rila Mountains, complementing an oasis of serenity perfect for religious hermits and modern visitors alike. Veliko Tarnovo, one of the oldest cities in Bulgaria.
There's so much green.
The city of the Tsars.
Trees. And...
Veliko Tarnovo is located next to the Yantra River. This was the historic capital of the second Bulgarian Empire between the 12th and 14th centuries. Veliko Tarnovo is located in central Bulgaria and is a popular tourist attraction. Tsarevets Fortress was where the medieval palaces of the Bulgarian Tsars were located, and they ruled from the hilltop until their defeat by the Ottomans in 1393. Still, one senses Bulgaria's former greatness when walking through the gates of this amazing stronghold. Plovdiv Old Town. A magnificent architectural and historical reserve. Plovdiv, the second largest city in Bulgaria, and has something that Sofia does not, an old town on a hill.
Look more developed.
The city was founded some 6,000 years ago and developed on 7 hills.
One of
them was destroyed at the beginning of the 20th century. The old town towers
cover
the city center with structures from different eras, including a remarkably well-preserved Roman amphitheater. The old town is best known for its Bulgarian Renaissance architectural style, with colorful houses displaying the National Revival's unique exterior characteristics on every corner. Walking up the hill is a delight, with the many galleries and house museums all worth a visit. Sizopol, a beautiful ancient seaside town.
One of the oldest
towns on Bulgaria's Black Sea coastline. Sizopol is a popular fisherman's village and seaside resort. Located 35 kilometers south of Burgas, Sizopol was known in the 6th century BC as Apollonia, complete with a temple dedicated to Apollo. The town is small enough for a casual stroll. The busiest times of the year are the summer months, ranging from May to September as tourists from around the world come to enjoy the weather.
There's so many
the
houses
beaches,
together.
The history, culture, and atmosphere of the
like, that's
resort.
Crazy. And they just different shapes, different positions.
Bulgarian countryside. Bulgaria is a country of roses, but it is also known worldwide for its unique yogurt made from cow milk. For potters' wheels and carpets, its fruits and vegetables, for traditional cookers, and much more. Visit the Bulgarian countryside to personally experience these Bulgarian highlights. Many of small villages and small towns have preserved the unique customs, traditions, culture, and crafts of the interesting past that this country has had. Don't miss the opportunity, you will enjoy it. And if
Hold on.
If you enjoy this video, subscribe to Foreigner BG.
Yeah, we gonna. Yeah. That nigga told me something. If you, I thought he was about to say, y'all had me gone. I thought I was in motherfucking Bulgaria, nigga. You hear me? Y'all let me know what's going on, man. That's crazy, bro. So, why didn't he mention Sofia? I know that's where, I know I'm out of Bulgaria. Everybody from Bulgaria better get in here and talk, tell, put, drop shit about facts, other cities, what's who and who live in the last city. Like, hip everybody to it, man. I did this especially for y'all. Like, I wanted to come and see what's going on. That's crazy. It's like, that shit, y'all country look like a, it's like a magical, like he said, like something out of a movie or a fairy tale or a castle. Like, that shit is crazy, bro. It's like, over here, so much streets, like concrete. Concrete and goddamn, we got y'all shitting on us with the trees. You know what I'm saying? And then, like, that, oh, damn, that's crazy. It was a little town on the Pearl of the Black Tongue. Whose name? I can't remember right now. But they live right on the edge of the ocean. Like, damn, I wish I could remember, yo. It was so much. But, yeah, that shit was interesting and shit, man. That shit hard. Y'all would definitely want to come down, bro. I ain't gonna lie. Like, at least come over there and kick it for a few days. Like, this COVID shit, you know. But, you know how that go, you know. So, I can't get to do with that. Really didn't mean to say that. But, you know what it is. Y'all let me know what y'all think. And all my Bulgarian people, please drop some comments in here. It don't got to just be play Bob Cotter and don't Marceau and fight. Tell me something. Let's tell the other people that's going to see this about, like, what they didn't mention. What they left out. What did these people leave out? You know what I'm saying? Let us know something, man. You know what I'm saying? Until next time. Yeah. Yeah.